Yesterday, the Uganda People's Defense Forces released a public warning urging the populace to remain vigilant against possible terror attacks, which is treated by ADF militants following intelligence reports indicating a fresh infiltration of ADF operatives into Ugandan territory. While appearing before the Parliamentary Committee on Trade and Tourism, the Chief Executive Officer of the Uganda Tourism Board, Lily Ajarova, noted that UPDF's public caution has not augured well with the tourism sector, as a number of tourists have cancelled their visits to Uganda. Ajarova added that more countries are issuing travel advisories to their citizens, discouraging them from travelling to Uganda, which is stifling the tourism sector.
We prioritized and put in $1.2 billion, but that is really very, very little, and we would appreciate if we can get another $4 billion to add on to that, because there's a lot of back and forth.
Uganda Tourism Board now plans to engage international media to improve Uganda's image on the global stage. In the coming financial year 2024-2025 budget, Uganda Wildlife Authority seeks 1.2 billion shillings to engage the international media houses in production of positive media stories for improved destination image.
From that press release of yesterday, we are going to get more negative travel advisories that will come up. So we must be able to counter that by bringing international media people who can actually be able to come and verify that it is safe, then they are able to report back.
We need money to engage international media houses, 1.2 billion. We need a breakdown of that 1.2 billion. What is planned within the 1.2 billion?
We have air tickets, we have the internal travel cost when we have to take.
We don't want it like that. We want it on paper.
Committee on Trade has queried officials from Uganda Wildlife Research and Training Institute over 1.8 million shillings that was spent on research to establish whether the Kenny rat meat is edible.
Action, you have only done research on that rat.
The Kenny rat.
The Kenny rat,
yes.
And you did research without even having the Kenny rat in your possession. How would you account for all this?
So we did it in the Rwenzori region, we did it in the northern region, we did it in the eastern region, and the results were showing that the Kenny rat meat can be accepted.
Imagine what research of 1.8 million on the Kenny rat. What did you do? 1.8 million, even the fuel alone to those regions can deplete it.
The committee has also queried the breakdown of 10 billion shillings to Uganda Wildlife Education Center to breed lions. MPs established that some activities itemized under this project have also been budgeted for by Uganda Wildlife Authority.
Apparently accounting for the 10 billion. Environmental impact assessment, 500 million for lion breeding. UWA has also provided environmental impact assessment on page 7. 280 million. So who of you is duplicating the other's work? You are both going to do environmental impact assessment.
About 16 lions. And this is called soft release. Take some time. There are details there, including monitoring, including transport. All those details are there. Not only feeding, not only what. The details are there.
Mwine Mpaka, the committee chairperson, asked the agency to present a comprehensive breakdown of the 10 billion shillings or lose the money.
You, on behalf of the committee, anything you cannot defend will not get a single coin. Go back, prepare your BOQs, tell us who prepared those BOQs, if it's a consultant. Did you procure that consultant? Are you aware of the law? If it's civil works, we are Ministry of Works, we are using consultants.
Report by Fred Kajuri for the news.